Welcome to the presentation on solving inequalities, or I guess we could call them algebraic inequalities. So let's get started. If I were to tell you that, let's just say x is greater than 5, right? So x could be 5.01, it could be 5.5, it could be a million, it just can't be 4 or 3 or 0 or negative 8. And actually, just for convenience, let's actually draw that on the number line. If that's the number line, and if this is 5, x can't be equal to 5, so we draw a big circle here, and then we would color in all the values that x could be. So x could be just the small, it could be 5.00001. It just has to be a little bit bigger than 5, and any of those would satisfy, right? So let's just write some numbers that satisfy. 6 would satisfy it, 10 would satisfy it, 100 would satisfy it. Now, if I were to multiply, or I guess divide, both sides of this, I guess we could say equation, or this inequality, by negative 1, I want to understand what happens. So what's the relation between negative x and negative 5? And when I say what's the relation, is it greater than or is it less than negative 5? Well, 6 is a value that works for x. So negative 6, is that greater than or less than negative 5? Well, negative 6 is less than negative 5, right? So let me draw the number line here. If we have negative 5 here, and let's just draw a circle around it because we know it's not going to be equal to negative 5 because we're just deciding between greater than or less than. So we're saying 6 works for x. So negative 6 is here, right? Negative 6. So negative 6 is less than negative 5. So is negative 10. So is negative 100. So is negative a million, right? So it turns out that negative x is less than negative 5. And this is really all you have to remember when you are working with inequalities in algebra. Inequalities, you can treat them just the way a greater than or less than sign, you could treat them exactly the way you would treat an equal sign. The only difference is if you multiply or divide both sides of the equation by a negative number, you swap it. That's all you have to remember. Let's do some problems, and hopefully that'll hit the point home. And if you ever forget, you just have to remember this. If x is greater than 5, well, the negative x is less than negative 5. And keep trying out numbers. That's what's going to give you the best intuition. Let's do some problems. So if I said that 3x plus 2 is, let's say, less than or equal to 1. Well, this is a pretty easy equation to solve. We just say 3x, let's subtract 2 from both sides. And when you do add or subtract, you don't do anything to the inequality. So if you subtract 2 from both sides, you get 3x is less than or equal to negative 1, right? And then now we're going to divide both sides by 3. We get x is less than or equal to negative 1/3. Right? And notice we didn't change anything because we divided both sides by a positive 3. Right? We could have actually done this equation in a slightly different way. What if we subtracted 1 from both sides? So this is another way of solving it. What if we said 3x plus 1 is less than or equal to 0, right? I just subtracted 1 from both sides. And now let's subtract 3x from both sides. And we get 1 is less than or equal to minus 3x, right? I subtracted 3x from here, so I have to subtract 3x from here. Now I would have to divide both sides by a negative number, right? Because I'm going to divide both sides by a negative 3. So I get negative 1/3 on this side. And based on what we had just learned, since we're dividing by a negative number, we want to swap the inequality, right? It was less than or equal, now it's going to be greater than or equal to x. Now, did we get the same answer when we did it both two different ways? Here we got x is less than or equal to negative 1/3. And here we got negative 1/3 is greater than or equal to x. Well, that's the same answer, right? X is less than or equal to negative 1/3. And that's I always find that to be the cool thing about algebra. You can tackle the problem in a bunch of different ways, and you should always get to the right answer as long as you, I guess, do it right. Let's do a couple more problems. Let's erase this thing. There you go. I'll do a slightly harder one. Let's say negative 8x plus 7 is greater than 5x plus 2. Let's subtract 5x from both sides. negative 13x plus 7 is greater than 2. Now we can subtract 7 from both sides. Negative 13x is greater than minus 5. Now we're going to divide both sides of this equation by negative 13. Well, very easy. It's just x, and on this side, negative 5 divided by negative 13 is 5 over 13, right? The negatives cancel out. And since we divided by a negative, we switch the sign. X is less than 5 over 13. And once again, just like the beginning, if you don't believe me, try out some numbers. And I remember when I first learned this, I didn't believe the teacher, so I did try out numbers, and that's how I got convinced that it actually works. When you multiply or divide both sides of this equation by a negative sign, you swap the inequality. And remember, that's only when you multiply or divide, not when you add or subtract. I think that should give you a good idea of how to do these problems. There's really not much new here. You would do an inequality, or I guess you could call this an inequality equation. You do it exactly the same way you would do a normal linear equation. The only difference being is if you multiply or you divide both sides of the equation by a negative number, then you swap the inequality. I think you're ready now to try some practice problems. Have fun.